Several weeks later, lawyers were going through her clothes, which no longer fit because she had gotten pregnant. Watching her 5 years old son asked, "Mom, now that you are going to have a baby, are you going to have to wear eternity clothes?" And so, eternity clothes. Are you going to wear eternity clothes? Eternity clothes, yes, it seemed that way at times. It seemed that way at times, right? They have to say, okay. And what of a wedding? The little boys were attending his first wedding. After the ceremony, his mother asked him, "Son, do you know how many women a man is allowed to marry?" He says, 16. 16 women, wow. A 5-year-old, 16. The boy expanded. His mother was shocked. "What do you mean, 16? "It's easy," the little boy said. "All you have to do is add it up. Like the pastor said, 4 better, 4 worse, 4 rich, 4 poor."
That's right.
For better, for worse, right? But he said 4. You add it together, it gives you 16. Well, that brought me to have some deep pockets. One more time. And one of the mothers in our church put her son to bed on the eve of his 5th birthday. She was trying to communicate that birthday ideas to him. "Kevin," she said, "this is the last night of your 4th birth night. Do you understand that?" Kevin was ready to communicate with his hands. For a 4-year, he has shown people 4 fingers for his 4 years. And now he was ready to add a tongue. Seeing this 4 fingers, his mother nodded and said, "When you go to sleep tonight, you will still be 4 years old. But do you know how old you will be in the morning when you wake up?" Kevin nodded enthusiastically, added his tongue to his 4 fingers, to his 4 little fingers, and said, "Tomorrow I will be a handful." Okay. A 5-year-old handful to you? No more 4 fingers. It's a handful. Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So every parent go through that. They go through, oh my goodness. 4 fingers. To end to a handful. How many handfuls children we have now in the school?
Oh my goodness.
In their kids.
All of them. Every one of them.
Handful of them, right? Oh, yes. Yeah. Some teachers, I just don't know how to deal with them. They will rise up early in the morning with a pleasant spirit to get to school. Oh my goodness. Some will go to school or even daycare centers. A few weeks ago in Chicago. Oh my goodness, we'll show you all the news. The teachers were so fed up with one of the children, and she brought the child out and put her on the bus. Just too bad because she didn't want to deal with it. In the broad daylight, someone took a picture of it. If it is not your calling, then don't commit to it.
Amen.
Do Can I repeat that once again?
It is a ministry.
Yeah. Taking care of children, especially other people's children in daycares and in schools. If it's not your calling, then do not commit yourself to it. If you are easily frustrated by little things they do, then just take yourself out of the equation. Somebody say,
praise the Lord.
Take yourself out of the equation. And don't need you rising up in the morning with a pleasant spirit. You go to a school setting or the daycare's facilities. Then your bright spirit turns to frustration. Come on now. Somebody shall say,
praise the Lord.
Knowing now the time we are in, that we don't have the kind of models we used to have in the 60s and 70s, even in the 50s. Models that used to take time to even take care of other people's children. We don't have those kind of models anymore. These models would pack the child out of the home, send them to school. The one for the teacher to teach them how to pile the train. They want the teacher to teach them how to wash dishes. They want for the teacher to teach them how to sweep to clean their room.
To
come on now.
That's right.
Is that right? They want for the teacher to teach them. Come on now.
Everything.
Manner raising. My scripture tells me that charity begins at home and then spread abroad.
That's right.
The parents are even home by themselves. They're not going to leave the children home by themselves. Television raising them. They get fed up with them, so they buy them cell phones to concentrate on the cell phone, cartoon and games. While real life teaching is passing them by. So I would tell the parents, prospective teachers and prospective daycare provider, if you know that it's not your calling, then do not commit yourself to it. It's easy said and done. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Let's go into our message. Judges chapter 4. Don't, notwithstanding, we stay here committed, loving mother, God is spiritual women out there, men as well, that are willing to make the sacrifice to see our children do good.
Amen.
There are mothers and fathers that are out there making the sacrifice, taking care of other people's children. Oh yes, we take our hat up to them. But as the saying goes, every apple tree has some bad one. Has some bad apples. But we are grateful to the mothers and the brothers out there that are coming up with creative programs to teach our children. There are some godly brothers and godly sisters out there. And we thank God for them. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Judges chapter 4.
Amen.
If you have your Bible, please turn. I want you to learn something.
Amen.
Judges chapter 4, beginning with the first verse. Then from there we'll go to the fifth chapter of the same book. Somebody say praise the Lord.
Judges
4:1 says, and the children of Israel again did evil in the sight of the Lord when Ehud was dead. And the Lord sold them into the hand of Jabin, king of the Canaanite, that reigned in Hazor, the captain of whose host was Sisera, which dwell in Herisha of the Gentiles. And the children of Israel cry unto the Lord, for he had got 900 cherubs of iron. And 20 years he mightily oppressed the children of Israel. Joshua had died. And the judges have been organized to carry on the tithes that was carried on by Moses and Joshua. There were no particular or one leader to lead the children of Israel. So a system of judges, that's what they call the book judges, a system of judges was set up to lead the people. And every now and then, they would choose one of their own to be the leader. But they did not have that godly anointing that Moses and Joshua had to enforce the law among the Israelites to be obedient to the work of God, to be obedient to the call of God. They were doing their own stuff. There were no direct enforcement of the rules or laws after the death of Joshua. After the death of Joshua, I said everybody was doing their own thing. And eventually Israel became a failed state. A failed state is a country that has no rules, that have no enforcement of the rules or laws. Yeah. People do their own thing. Gangs arise and take control. Criminal empire increase. When the laws are on the book of the land, when it is not enforced, crime increase. That's what Ecclesiastes says. Because men do not execute the law of the Lord, immediately crime increase. And that was what happened with Israel after the death of Joshua. Crime increased, but people were even afraid to walk on highways. People were afraid to walk in the city streets. There was too much of bloodshed. There was too much of criminal activities going on. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say, glory to God. Then it came to the past, one of the reasons that these things were on the increase, the Bible said the Israelites went after different gods. They invented their own god. They went after fortune tellers. They went after idols, became idol worshippers. So they drove God out of their midst. And when God is not in your midst, what you expect? Is that right? What you see is the reproach of any nation. Somebody say, Lord, we thank you.
Lord, we thank you.
So the Bible said, because of their disobedience, stiff-neckedness, God sold them in the hands of their enemies. And they had a general that afflicted them for 20 years, a Syria for 20 years, and they were looking for a deliverer. They were looking for a deliverer to come and deliver them from the hands of this general. The scripture said, the 10th verse said, and the children of Israel cry unto the Lord, for he had 900 chariots of iron in 20 years. He mightily oppressed the children of Israel. And Deborah, remember now, Deborah is not a name of a man, but a name of a woman.
That's right. Yes, it is.
So, come on now.
That's right.
Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And Deborah, I want you to understand that.
Hallelujah, it was
Deborah's
time.
Okay, well, Deborah time.
That's right.
Somebody said, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because we are in a time now where some churches don't like to see women in power.
Well,
The thing that God never elevated